So this is what the standalone Wanker water anchor looks like in the fully open position without any of the drain ends rolled and closed. Now, as you can see, the yellow plastic covered cable has 550 parachute cord attached to it, and this can be used as a pull rope. It's 550 pound braking strain. We use it for skydiving, and it's much lighter to carry and can easily be used to pull this. The pull is so easy, it's probably maybe at the most maybe a 5 pound pull, that's it. And you can attach a heavier 8mm rope to that if you want, or just a continual long 550 cord, which is much easier to carry through a canyon. When pulling the cable through and tightening this, make sure that the little washer is free and not jamming anywhere in the system. So this is what the bottom drain of the standalone Wanker looks like when it has been rolled, the cables put through both loops. It is now ready to be filled. And this is how the Wanker looks in the fully closed position with the bottom and top rolls closed with cables through the loops. The only time this would ever be used is in a very shallow slope on a pothole where you need to close the top as well. Now, after setup in the pothole filled with water, ready to rappel, it is essential that the pull rope is safety tied to the water anchor in some fashion, like this, with a rapide or a carabiner, to prevent any pull accidentally of the actual cable out of the water anchor. It's also highly essential that a big loop is made underneath the wrap rope, so the tension of the wrap rope over the edge of the pothole keeps this from being pulled accidentally with a lot of pressure down of the repellers on that wrap rope. Now, the last repeller must make sure that this has been disconnected, so that you obviously, when you get to the bottom, you can pull the drain rope or pull rope freely. So that'll go over the edge, and then make sure you have your big loop underneath right at the point of most pressure on the wrap rope going over the edge of the pothole. What we have here now is about 10 gallons of water. You can see there's no leaks. If there was a few drips, it wouldn't matter, but there's no leaks at the bottom now. And that is sufficient on a hanging pothole like this. We don't even have to close the top. Just leave it open for topping up later if necessary. Okay, the last repeller is down. He loosened the safety at the top, and now we'll pull the release cable. See, that's a maximum 5 second complete drain.
Full body, it's not moving. Tom is jumping up and down right now on the Wanker. You can see there's hardly any movement. This thing is not budging at all. Okay. Tom's at the bottom. He's pulling the release. There it goes. Little weight. There's the drain.
Okay, release the pull. You can watch, see the pull cord, super easy release. I can already see it starting to bulge. That's gonna be good. I think just a little more weight. It's so close. There, oh, that was it. Oh, there it is. It's starting to unflap. It's starting. It's unflapped. Hold for a sec. Hold. Yeah, much better.
Okay.
Yeah. So Tom's at the bottom. He's pulling the release. There it goes. Little weight. Wanker's draining. And motoring over the cliff edge.
Now, when rolled correctly on the top side, instead of underneath, this is what it should look like. Now this is lying on a completely flat surface, and as you can see on the pull, it rolls very easily, unrolls, and drains completely. Because of the flat surface and about almost 30 gallons of water we had in here, it probably takes about 15 to 20 seconds to drain. So make sure whenever you set it up that it is rolled towards the top, the roll on the top.
Full body, it's not moving. Tom is jumping up and down right now on the wanker. You can see there's hardly any movement. This thing is not budging at all.
Okay. Tom's at the bottom. Pulling the release. There it goes. Little weight. Okay, release the pull. You can watch, see the pull cord, super easy release. I can already see it starting to bulge. That's gonna be good. I think just a little more weight. It's so close. There, oh, that was it. Oh, there it is. It's starting to unflap. It's starting, it's unflapped. Hold for a sec. Hold. Yeah, much better.
Okay.
Yep. So Tom's at the bottom. He's pulling the release. There it goes. Little weight. Wanker's draining. And motoring over the cliff edge. Tom Sealy on the wanker, flat-ish ground test.
slight angle, fairly featureless sloping hill.
Good to go.